white peacock. What can it mean? What are those creatures that chase it? But see, Rangda has the soldiers under her spell.
A fresh mortal at the gate? Greetings, little fly. Welcome to my web.
A city of such beautiful waters, but the waters are now choked with poison. There used to be many more lotus flowers.
They always brought me such joy. And Raji can grow more, if only she thinks of it. The shrine to mighty Lord Vishnu. This must be Hiranyanagari. I have heard such tales of this place.
She recognizes the city built to your glory. Are you not pleased, O Vishnu?
It was my city, indeed. Built to house my temple. But it is no longer mine. A great shadow has fallen over it. Demons of Rangda, in my city.
Her shadow is long.
You must defeat them, Raji.
She cannot hear you, but she knows what to do.
See what they built in my name. A magnificent city, a prosperous city filled with marvels. Delicate carvings and intricate mechanisms, mills powered by water, wheels that turn other wheels, that open gates and lift great weights.
Jalasura, demons of water, mechanical slaves to Ranga. Careful, careful, my Raji. Avoid their gaze.
Peacock, it cries out. Is it hurt?
Thank you.
Do you remember what I keep in my temple, Durga?
Of course. That gives her a chance. But the way is blocked. Look, the Gajan waters are high.
There are mechanisms to lower them. But what does she know of cocks and wheels?
She is clever, this girl. She will find a way.
Guardians of Hiranya. They are restless. Something is wrong.
Randa has corrupted even the fish.
It can be put right, Vishnu. It is why we are here.
She must cleanse this, Durga. She must cleanse all of this.
She will. And perhaps the tree will grant her another vision of the future.
What did this being want with Golu? To instruct him? To control him? Raji did not know what I knew. Here lay our greatest peril.
To think that there is fighting even in places of worship.
There is worship and fighting if it is for the right cause.
Thank you.
This little fly has a sting. Who is this intruder, and why does she dare my wrath?
With me.
Thank you.
The waters drain.
It is not enough. There is more to do. Another mechanism to find.
She must hurry. We do not want Rangda to notice until Raji is prepared.
Thank you. But what about us, Didi? Why do we have no mother, no father?
They are up there, in the stars, little brother.
Do not test me!
This is a place of cunning. The mills, the water that feeds the green fields. There is no denying it is clever, Vishnu. It is such a concentration of power. And now it is in Rangda's hands.
I am not scared of you.
These people have no will. Their minds are clouded by Rangda's shadow. And so the city was taken without any way to fight back.
But they are alive, and so they can be freed. Most dear of wives, of Maharshi Kashyap. He granted each a boon to show his affection. Kadru asked to become the mother of 1,000 sons. Vinita asked for just one son, but that he must be more powerful than the 1,000 sons of Kadru. Blessed by the Maharshi, Kadru gave birth to 1,000 eggs. Vinita gave birth to only 2 eggs. With time, Kadru's eggs began to hatch. Inside each one was a coiling snake. Vinita, impatient and jealous that her sister's eggs had already hatched, took it upon herself to break open one of her own eggs. Inside Vinita's egg was a half-formed bird-like creature. Enraged by his mother's actions, he cursed her, saying that she would be a slave to Kadru until her second egg hatched. And if she did not show patience with that hatching, she would forever be a slave. And so, under the curse of a half-formed offspring, and through the machinations of Kadru and her Naga children, Vinita became a slave to her sister. Years passed until one day Vinita's second egg finally hatched. From it emerged Garuda, the king of birds. Seeing his mother's servitude, Garuda asked the Nagas to free her. They agreed, but on the condition that Garuda would fly to heaven and fetch for them the elixir of immortality. Garuda, for his mother's sake, flew to the heaven of the Devas. He was too powerful for the Devas to defeat, and so seized the elixir from them. I saw that Garuda did not want the elixir for himself, and so I manifested myself to him. Because his heart was pure, I granted him the gift of immortality. In return, he granted me the gift of becoming my mount, should I so desire it. I warned Garuda of the deceptive nature of the Nagas. So Garuda returned to the Nagas with the elixir, but tricked them, telling them that it could only be consumed after they had purified themselves in the holy river. He attacked them unsuspecting as they bathed and ate them up. He freed his mother, Vinita. For safekeeping, Brahma took the elixir and bore it back to the heavens. This is one of the mechanisms that will lower the Gajan waters. Is it too much for her?
Cogs and levers. This is no challenge compared to fighting demons.
Thank you.
can reach Lord Vishnu's temple.
Well done, Raji.
Maybe there I can find help.
The waters flow, my poison dispelled. You will suffer for this trespasser.